Alright, so I've been driving, and every time I brake, I've been experiencing an unusual impact from the caravan onto the vehicle. This could be either a coupler shock failure or an incorrect brake setting. In this case, it was a coupler shock failure. I will now show you how to replace your coupler shock. In my caravan's case, I've got my jockey wheel on the side of the A-frame here. It's not the case in your van. Make sure to secure the front of the trailer with a jack underneath the A-frame. You can easily identify a failed coupler shock by compressing your coupler, and if it's very easily compressible, you know that's a failed coupler shock. Do this replacement needing 5 tools. Firstly, a number 19 spanner and 19 socket if possible, otherwise two 19 spanners will work. A long screwdriver, and if possible a crowbar or a second long screwdriver. And most importantly, a tarpaulin to work cleanly in the bush. Start by removing the four bottom nuts that keeps your coupler in place. After removing the four nuts, remove the bottom plate. After removing the bottom plate, remove the front bolt of the coupler shock. Next, remove the rear bolt of the coupler shock. Once the coupler shock is out, you then take the new one. You'll feel that the compression on this is almost non-compressible with your bare hands. Start by installing the front part first. Once you've compressed the shock enough to get into the cavity, use something like a crowbar, which has got enough leverage to get behind the shock. Maybe even a second screwdriver. Replace the nut as well. Make sure that it's nice and tight. Then put your bottom plate back. It's very important to make sure that these bolts are very tight.